Hi, everybody. Marty Rubin, and I'm back for another segment of Marty's Corner. You never know who's going to show up. We have Haley Root, who is playing the all-American teenage girl.
Kim MacAfee.
Yes, yes, yes. Who gets the honor, right, of getting the kiss from Conrad Birdie. How did you get so lucky, Haley, to be chosen as the young high school girl to be kissed by Conrad Birdie?
Oh my gosh. Well, me, I auditioned for the role, but I watched the movie growing up. I always loved this movie.
It's a great movie.
Oh yeah. I watched the one with Anne Margaret and Dick Van Dyke specifically.
Exactly.
And I...
Did she give you inspiration for Anne Margaret doing it?
Yeah. Absolutely. And so, yeah, I went into the audition with this a lot of history of knowing the show very well. But then it was just kind of like, how can I put my own spin on it? Obviously, I took a lot of inspiration from her, but, you know, just how can I make Kim my own and, bringing parts of 15-year-old Haley into the role.
Right. I mean, everybody loves Bye Bye Birdie. They all said that they saw the movie, they grew up with the movie. So you mentioned 15-year-old, Kim MacAfee.
Mm-hmm.
You're not that much past 15, but you're past your high school years.
Yeah.
How do you call yourself back to be a 15-year-old girl again?
Mm-hmm. Well, I actually journaled around that time, and I remember writing down a lot of my firsts. So I remember, the first time I was shopping for makeup. I remember the first couple of times that I started doing like womanly things, buying like more adult style clothes.
Right.
I think it was kind of funny looking back on some of the things that I had written and
like a little diary.
Like using that. And I mean, in the, in our blocking, like I even hold up a bra that's like way too big for me. It's like definitely mother's bra. Like, and I think like all of those things are very universal. And I even love that there are women out in the audience that are way past 15 that can laugh at that because they remember exactly those years.
Because
they're a really big deal.
Who was your heartthrob back then as a 15-year-old?
We actually talked about that one of our first days of rehearsal. We all went around and talked about who our Conrad Birdie was. And mine was definitely One Direction. And I remember getting to a place where I felt very Kim and like, this is maybe too past me. And they had come to Florida, and I was like, I guess I'll go to the concert, and I lost my mind. So it was like, definitely One Direction for me is what I hone in on when I'm on stage. I'm like, think about what Harry Styles made you feel.
That's a great backstory for how you might react to Conrad Birdie.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right. Did you ever see the movie Big with Tom Hanks?
Uh-huh.
So I was watching an interview with him because he goes back and plays like a 12-year-old,
mm-hmm.
Boy. And they were asking him, how were you able to transform yourself back? And, he mentioned something about, the excitement that you have when you're a young kid or, that you would exaggerated moves or, just over-the-top energy, Is that how you envision playing a 15-year-old?
I think so. I also think a big thing that I try to do is Kim is putting on a front of much more mature than she is.
Right.
And so I think that I like to find moments in the show where she is awkward and like maybe the nerves of seeing Conrad Birdie for the first time would cause her to turn her feet in a little bit more like giggle a little too loud. So I think
you did that well, the
excitement is there, it's just then turned and I try to put it into this kind of nervous awkward energy because it's when her true 15 comes out and then she'll put the front back on. I'm an adult. But yeah, I think that's what I really try to incorporate in my body language is this nervousness.
When he's doing, John Drinkwater is playing, Conrad Birdie, and when he's singing, Give Me One Last Kiss, and it's supposed to be for you.
Uh-huh.
And he's shaking his hips and going crazy and he does a great job at it. And everybody's fainting on stage. Do you get like an extra adrenaline rush? Like, okay, this is what's going on and he's coming over to me and
Absolutely, absolutely. The first time we really lock eyes on stage, I guess the second time, but in Honestly Sincere, it is kind of, that's the like starting moment of, oh my gosh, he's chosen me, and not only has he chosen me, he's going to kiss me later in the show. And I think John does such a great job at it because he's got such a pop star energy in himself.
Right, right.
So, I mean, that is very helpful. But I'm on stage, I'm freaking out, and then I've got my whole ensemble on stage too that's also freaking out, and you can't help but like feel that energy. And you can feel it in the audience. They're feeling
it too.
It's like, oh my gosh, he's a star.
Everybody's relating to you, you know,
yeah.
And it's fun. Where did you grow up, Haley?
So I grew up in Tallahassee, Florida.
Oh, okay.
And then my dad also.
A Miami Marlin fan or what kind of family?
So I've never had an NFL team, I will say that, but I did grow up right next to Florida State, so I was a Seminole
fan.
My family was a college football fan. I would say that I'm a Seminole fan, but really, I'm an Auburn Tiger fan. My whole family went to Auburn University,
so
I'm really an Auburn fan, and then, of course,
they're always good.
They're always great, and then my college, I went to University of Cincinnati, so I always root for them, too.
That's good. So, when did you come to New York?
So I came to New York this past August, so about a year ago now. So I'm still a newbie when it comes to New York. I still feel most comfortable in Florida or Cincinnati, but I'm getting used to the New York lifestyle.
Well, you know, it's a little slower pace in Florida, but you have a quick pace about you. You know, did you have to find an adjustment, like coming from a slower pace? Now you live in a city?
Yeah.
So, you know, living in the city, you know, you're auditioning for shows and things. Did it take a period of adjustment for you to get with the rhythm of New York?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I love New York and it's really great, but it just, to your point, the pace is unlike any other city. You're constantly moving. And I think the other thing too is I didn't realize how much I love driving, but I love to drive. And
but you're only 15 years old.
Yeah, exactly. I love to drive, but I loved driving, so I miss that a lot. Like, and I think walking everywhere is that takes a whole other energy level, and it's tiring to go, you know, a 30 minute commute when you're in your car, you're just sitting jam into your music, but walking in the heat and carrying your bags, it's very different. So that was a huge transition. It was hard. I feel like just now I'm starting to kind of be like, I get it. I know what subway line I'm taking. I know how to get to the Long Island Railroad now. It's all starting to settle in.
When you get to the Babylon Station, it's an
easy
walk, right?
It's easy. When I get to Babylon, I'm like, oh, this feels a little bit more like home.
Now when you get to Babylon and you're walking down Deer Park Avenue, is that when you're getting into Kim MacAfee mode?
I think, I think the train is a really good place to start, where I get about an hour to just listen to music and get in the zone. But really, when I start doing my makeup in the dressing room is when I start to zone in.
Right.
And then, you know, put my wig on and you're in the character at that point. But I think there's something about, well, not only with Kim, it's so perfect because she's trying on makeup and all these things for the first time, but there is something about getting my face ready and getting my hair ready that feels so accurate for this character. So it's a really good moment to zone in for me.
Yeah. So when you went to high school, obviously, in Florida, mm-hmm. as a 15-year-old, could you go back and what would you think 15-year-old Haley Root would think of you playing Kim MacAfee right now at the Argyle Theater?
She would definitely be like, I knew you would do it, because I feel like I probably manifested this role for myself for a very long time. And I think the other thing would be that she would be really excited that I'm, you know, a working actor. That was always my dream,
was to
be able to, you know.
Was that your first love, acting? Because you got a beautiful voice.
Yeah.
But was acting or singing?
I think probably acting, and then I started taking voice lessons, but I was always in theater. I think I started doing shows probably like in the fourth grade or something like that. I started doing Annie, and I think I always found a love for theater, but I took my voice a lot more seriously when I got into high school and started taking like very serious voice lessons. But yeah, acting and musical theater as a whole has always been my love. So I think 15-year-old me would be like, you did it, you moved to New York, and look, now you're doing a dream show that you always wanted to do. So
that's nice.
Yeah.
Can you give a word of advice to, let's say there's young people watching this and they want to get into the theater business, and they might be in high school shows or middle school shows.
Yeah.
Like, what kind of advice could you give them? Because you're still young and not that past high school.
Yeah.
What kind of advice could you give them about the business?
I think the biggest thing is to be true to yourself. There are so many people that do musical theater now and go into college for musical theater and audition, and what makes you unique is that you're yourself and there's no one else like you.
Right.
With that being said, though, it's super important to take classes and hone all the things that make you unique and really special. So I mean, if there is a youth theater program, join that, join your high school choir, take voice lessons,
right.
Take a dance class. You know, I think that's just the best place to learn. You're learning from other kids, you're learning from teachers, and I think you really get to hone your craft. And I did that all throughout middle school, high school, and then into college. And the thing that I had to always kind of remind myself was, I'm training to be the best version of myself and not to be a carbon copy of somebody else. And that's hard to do in musical theater. It's very easy to be like, I gotta do exactly this, and I've gotta sing exactly like this, and I've gotta be able to kick my face here. And I think it's just a good reminder to just remember that you are special because you're you, because you're John, because you're Sonia. Like,
did you have a good mentor in high school, a teacher or a director of shows that gave you advice that you found really helpful?
I had so many. I mean, all throughout high school, I took a lot of course classes and a lot of theater classes. But I think specifically once I got into college, I had teachers that really transformed the way that I viewed theater and performing. Vince DeGeorge was one of my acting teachers back at CCM, and I just think he clarified so many things for me as a performer and brought me such peace as a performer. And I owe so much of what I do on stage now to him, and he knows that. And
that's nice.
So it is really special to have teachers like that that you can always go to.
Right. Did you know anybody in the cast of Bye Bye Birdie when you auditioned and started?
I knew Randy, who played Hugo, and
does a great job.
We were kind of talking about that, but what I didn't get to tell you is, first day of rehearsal, I talked to Sonia, and we were both from Florida. Sonia's from South Florida, and I'm from North Florida, so we were like, we probably wouldn't know each other. And she actually told me that she went to school in Tallahassee for about 2 years, and then stayed in Tallahassee for a little bit longer than that. So she knew multiple of my theater high school teachers.
Oh,
and we were
okay.
Like, that is the craziest world. And so it's kind of weird. The world continues to get smaller and smaller and smaller.
And so it's so nice to see, because a lot of times you don't know each other, the bonding. You know, I always relate it to, you know, to sports, you know, that the really good teams are the ones that bond,
mm-hmm.
that pull for each other. You know, that, you know, of course talent is a given. You have to have talent.
Mm-hmm.
But you need the support of everybody behind you, because they're going to make you better.
Absolutely. And that was such a special moment with Sonia and I, to be like, you know, immediately day one, we have something that we can relate on, and that's going to allow us to make an immediate connection on stage. Now this whole cast is so unbelievably close.
Yes,
and
really talented.
So talented, so close, and we really do all have each other's backs. And it feels very lucky to now have a whole nother group of 20 plus besties now.
Yes, that's very nice.
Yeah, it's very special.
You know, we mentioned earlier you have, you know, a beautiful voice. You have a number of really good songs in the show. I always look forward to hearing you sing. There's one particular favorite of mine, you know, and you mentioned it earlier about Kim is like starting to become a young woman.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how lovely to be a young woman.
Mm-hmm.
Would you give the Argyle Theater fans a little taste of what that song is like?
I would love to.
Oh, that's great.
How wonderful to know the things a woman knows. How marvelous to wait for a date in simply beautiful clothes. How lovely to be a woman and change from boys to men. To go to a fancy nightclub and stay out after 10. How lovely to be so grown up and free. Life's lovely when you're a woman like me.
Woo! Haley Root. Oh my God, that was great. Oh man, that was great. You got to come out and hear that entire song and get a chance to see Haley Root and the rest of this super talented cast in Bye Bye Birdie. We play Wednesday through Sunday straight through to September 1st, and we can't wait to see you at the Argyle Theater.